if they have something to say, you say, check yourself, not me, boo. Hey guys, today I'm here to talk about why you need to watch this video before you go and snippity snip 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 these locks off of your head top, okay? I make videos about hair, Atlanta content, and business stuff, so definitely go ahead and subscribe before I continue on. All right, cool, boom. Number one, don't just cut and go. Have a style for your face frame. No matter, you know, we all know, you can even Google it yourself, everybody's head shape is different. What hairstyle might fit you? Definitely follow those reference guides you see online. But this tip is also very weird at the same time for me, because I feel like if you really want a style, just go ahead and do it. No matter your head shape, your how full your face is, or how narrow it is, or how long, or whatever, definitely do what you want, essentially. But don't just be like, wake up in the morning and say, I'm gonna cut my hair. Like, you can, but just have a plan. Because once you cut your hair, it's gone. You know what I'm saying? You can't glue it back together, basically, is what I'm trying to say. Next one. Short hair is very versatile. Don't let anybody tell you that, oh, when you have short hair, you're confined to the style that you have. Essentially, yes. You know, because, like, right here, I can't put a ponytail in my hair. You know what I mean? But I can do so many different things. Change your mindset to what you consider like confined. You know, you can put lines in your hair. You can fade the sides. You can do an undercut kind of line design. You can round out your edges. You can color it blue, pink, purple, red, green, whatever. And the cool thing about color is that with short hair, you can have it green, and then like 2 weeks later, 3 weeks later, you can cut it off and do another color, or you can just cut it off and go back to your natural state and like it never existed, because you can keep cutting your hair and starting over new colors. So that's like the best part of being a short hair natural girl. And even the cooler thing is, once you cut off this hair, you now have virgin, now you have virgin natural hair. There's nothing been processed with that hair, nothing. So like, you're starting anew like every 2-3 weeks or a month or whatever, however your cutting schedule will be. I talk on my hands, y'all, just ignore it. I'm putting my hands down, I'm sorry. Even the cool thing about it is that when you decide if you want to wear wigs or anything, your hair will lay flat. I mean, can't get no flat in your own head, you know? The third thing that's very important, very, very, very important, find a trusted barber, whether that's a reference from other friends who have other short haircuts, or somebody who's like a celebrity hairstylist or anything. Find a trusted barber that has experience with cutting the hairstyle that you want. And not just, oh, they did a fade on that person, I'm gonna fade. Like, did they do the fade exactly how you want it? Like, let's say you want a, like a more feminine cut. You know, with men haircuts, it's a lot of more structure, there's lineups, there's all of that. If you don't want to take that route and you want to go a more feminine touch, you might need to find somebody who has experience or has mastered woman haircuts. Just a thought to think about for sure. Don't just go down to your local barbershop and you don't really know much about what they specialize in. And please, if you do your own haircuts, which is what I do, or I let my mom or somebody do it for me, but when I did it in August 2019, I'd done my haircuts a couple of times, but this time in August 2019, I didn't put the guard on the razor, and so your girl was bald headed. And so I grew my hair from then until literally last week, so that's about 6 months. I grew my hair out. Hated how it grew because I didn't take care of it. And so here I am today with my hair cut once again, thinking I was going to grow my hair out. Here I am doing what I know, which is short and simple. Okay? So just a heads up, please put the guard on if you are not trying to achieve a completely bald look. The next one is important. You do not have to wear makeup and earrings, get your eyebrows did, and get lip fillers, whatever craziness. You don't have to do all that. Just because you're bald, just because you're short hair, just because you're TWA, whatever words you want to use, to be fly. Like, you don't need to do all that. Do your typical get ready routine, your simple grooming routines. Don't be above and beyond just because now your face is all exposed and you're not hiding behind your tresses. But it does challenge you. It does make you more intentional with picking your accessories because now they're more, you know, seen, more loud because it's right there in front of people's face. It's not hidden by strands of hair or anything. Do the best you can. Do what makes you happy. Do follow your own style. If you want to find some really cute, trendy earrings or anything, I do make earrings. I have an earring business. It's called Thrillobe. I talked about it on my channel before. I now make clay earrings and button earrings. And so this is my first line. It's in my first line of my clay earrings. And this is the Medusa earrings. And you can get it like two-tone like this, or you can get all pink or all green. So I just wanted to shout myself out and check out my earring business in the description box below. Enough about me. The next one. Don't dye your hair too much. So I know earlier I said you can do the pinks, the purples, the greens, and the reds, but space them out a little bit, because especially if you want to bleach your hair and do it blonde and everything, definitely space it out because your scalp is going to get sensitive. So even though you don't really care about the health of your hair, maybe because it's short, you can cut it off and start over, you definitely want to take care of the scalp that you have because your scalp is exposed to all those chemicals. And so you want to make sure you're taking care of your scalp as much as, if anything, when you have short hair, it's all about scalp maintenance and less about hair maintenance. So just be wary about how you take care of your scalp. And I can make a video about scalp care because it's such a different ball game with scalp, just being exposed to all of your scalp than scalp and hair like you had when you have longer hair. I know last year, for a little bit of time, I was doing back-to-back hair dyes, and my scalp was so sensitive. I never had sensitive scalp my entire life. I never was tender-headed, or what people like to call it. I was never that. And so, like, for a couple of months last year, I was tender-headed because I decided to back-to-back-to-back it. And once I, like, took that whole six-month hiatus that I took to grow my hair off for a little bit, my scalp was like, thank you. You know what I'm saying? So just be wary. And like with my hair color, for instance, even though it's like a blondish vibe, like red blonde, like whatever, this was no bleach. So like I find ways to do colors without incorporating really, really harmful things. Yes, I have bleached before, and yes, I plan to do it one sometime down the road, but not like I'm back to backing the bleach. I might bleach one time and then don't bleach again for like a couple of months or a couple of weeks or whatever. The next tip I'm gonna tell y'all for real, oil and brush is all you really need. Of course, water too, obviously, but oil and a brush, like a hard old school, like your brother's brush, you're gonna need that because you need to lay down your hair, you need to moisturize your scalp. Your scalp loves oils. Not too much cream. If you have cream, that's fine, but I'm talking about like a dime, like half a dime size if you have my length. But oil is permanent. But yes, oil is another part of that scalp care I was talking about. You need that. Brushing is to make sure that your hair lays in the direction that you want it to lay when it's time for your aesthetic, how you want to look. So that's definitely important. And the last tip, y'all, very last tip, be yourself and be confident. And I know that's such a like cheesy thing to say, for real, but people are going to challenge you and say, oh my god, why you cut your hair, you look so good with your hair, when why you had it. I mean, not saying that this isn't cute, but I mean, the short hair is cute and all, but I really like your hair long. Don't listen to them. If they have something to say, you say, check yourself, not me, boo. Be yourself and be confident. You decided to cut your hair, whether that's for a big chop, whether that's for a change, whether that's for whatever. If you're still planning on the feel about cutting your hair or not, just do it. What do you have to lose? Hair? Okay, grows back. You want to wear, you want your hair to look long one day, you're like, I'm going to miss the long versatility of it. Okay, put a wig on. I mean, I really just want everybody to try something that they have the heart to try. If you have the heart to try something, just try it. Don't let these people hold you back. And that's on period, poop. That's pretty much it. I just wanted to do this little video and kind of just explain myself why I cut my hair and why you should or shouldn't cut your hair just based on what I said. And so let me know down below, what are some, if you are a hair chopper, what are some things you want people to know about hair being short? Because it's a real thing out there. And like, I know like some people say, don't cut your hair in the wintertime because it's cold. That's my philosophy. But my hair was a hot mess. I had to cut it before wintertime was over. Okay, thanks for watching. I'll catch you on the next video. Definitely check out my earrings, thrillobe.com, link down below. And let me know if you're gonna chop your hair or not. I would love to know. I want a community of bald head queens and kings, okay? All right, bye.